Good evening from Washington, D.C., and thank you for joining us for News from a Catholic Perspective. I'm Wyatt Goolsby, in for Lauren Ashburn. The Vatican defrocks former Cardinal Theodore McCarrick after finding him guilty of sexual abuse. The 88-year-old is the highest-ranking churchman to be dismissed from the clergy. McCarrick served as Archbishop in Washington, D.C. before his retirement. His appeal Friday was turned down by Pope Francis. He was once a prince of the church and a friend of presidents. Former Washington, D.C. Cardinal Theodore McCarrick enjoyed a spectacular career at the heart of power, in Washington and in Rome. When the U.S. Cardinals were summoned to the Vatican by John Paul II in 2002, at the beginning of the sex abuse scandal, Cardinal McCarrick was the reassuring face of that crisis, advocating zero tolerance for abusers, even as there were unrevealed allegations against him.
I can't see how anyone in the United States today would cover up something like that.
Theodore McCarrick was created a cardinal in 2001 by John Paul II. Around that time, an American priest wrote to the Vatican to warn them of rumors the cardinal was sexually abusing seminarians. But no action was taken for years until, according to the Vatican, under Benedict XVI. McCarrick was quietly advised not to travel or be seen in public and live a discreet life of prayer and penance to avoid further rumors of his sexual misconduct with seminarians, a recommendation which the cardinal seemed to ignore as he continued traveling and appearing in public, even at the 2013 conclave that elected Pope Francis. But then, in June last year, accusations McCarrick had abused a minor were found credible by an internal church investigation in New York. Although McCarrick maintained his innocence, he resigned as cardinal. Finally, he was brought to trial at the Vatican, though by now 88 years old, he did not attend in person. Phil Saviano was abused as a child and became central to the Boston Globe's investigation of pedophilia priests in the Boston area. He is praising the Vatican's decision, but remains cautious.
I'm hoping that this is not a situation where Pope Francis is throwing a bone to his dissenters in an attempt to quiet everybody down, and then McCarrick will be the one and only. Because there are certainly many others who have allegations against him who should face some accountability.